1973, Jimmy Bloomfield was in his third year as manager, and he'd built a strong team capable of matching the very best. In October of that year, Leeds United were very much the leading force in the land. They arrived at Filbert Street on top of the First Division, unbeaten in 10 matches, and with a 100% away record of 5 wins out of 5. City, lying in 7th place, gave them a real run for their money.
Whitworth, a little space in front of him to attack. Aiming for Stringfellow. Samuels, on for Worthington. The touch! Oh, beautiful goal! Oh, yes, indeed! Brad Worthington, 1-0. 10 minutes into the first half. That move, building up again then, from Whitworth hitting the long ball, Stringfellow knocking it back to Samuels, a beautifully judged lob forward, and Frank Worthington on the end of it. Roaf with this free kick. Virginal under it, Hunter was up highest. Rebner just hoists it high in the air. It's Whitworth, Bates, Whitworth, the head tennis stops, Weller. Beautifully done, Weller. Stringfellow trying to knock it back to one of his own men. He wasn't there. Stringfellow gets another bite. Chance on for Birchenhall. A whack one. And it's a beautiful goal. What about that one with his left foot? 2-0, Leicester. And he's mauled by that Leicester team on how he deserves it. That one goes into the book as a qualifier for the goal of the season. Alan Birchenhall. There was just nothing on at all as Stringfellow backheels this ball, but the dipping, swerving shot that came in left Harvey absolutely stranded and speechless. 2-0. Hunter for Madeley. Searching for Clark. Bates, early for Giles. Lorimer under this. Good ball, Jones! Yes, indeed. Mick Jones pulls one back. So now it's 2-1. Just wondering whether Peter Lorimer might just have got a touch with his hand as that ball came over Roach's head. But the ball he knocked in then for Mick Jones made scoring more or less a formality, even against a goalkeeper as good as Shilton. Dennis Roach is a very talented fullback. Won himself an under-23 cap last summer. Queen out as far as Samuels. That's a beautiful shot, a fabulous save. John Samuels really getting that one the hammer. Glover getting it back for Roaf, and that's only as far as Bremner. People to work out this throw-in situation. Lorimer for Bremner. A little bit slow. Jones back for Cherry. Bates wide for Madeley. Hunter. Now Giles. And Woollett comes away with it. But they say he handled the ball. So, an awkward free kick for the Leicester defenders again. Giles through, Bremner, and he's allowed it! He has allowed the goal! It's 2-2 and Bremner scored it! Well, there was a case of the Leicester players at sixes and sevens, not sure whether the wall was back far enough, but Giles spotted the confusion, knocked a quick ball through, and Bremner gets on the end and beats Shilton. 2-2. David Harvey. This break now at Birmingham, so supremely in control at Leeds. Jones for Bremner. Lorimer's the ball on. Lorimer going against Roaf. It's a naughty cross. Shilton caught it well. Whitworth, Samuels, Stringfellow. Whitworth. Weller. A bit tight in there. Less than 2 minutes for this 2-2 situation to be altered. Weller. Worthington, if he can keep it in. Yes, he does. Good ball for Samuels on again. And well read by Lorimer. Jones wide to the right. Now Bremner. Bremner for Madeley. Not much of this game left now. Just about a minute. Might be enough. Hunter. Jones. What a fine save! Gorgeous save from this man Jones by Peter Shilton.
On the way to winning the championship, Leeds went on to extend their unbeaten run from the start of the season to a record 29 games. But their record run never came as close to being cut short as it did at Filbert Street.